Hi there, I'm Christopher. And if we're going to have a demo set of videos, we're going to put together a beginner set of videos, we're of course obligated, required by law almost, to do Hello World. So let's do exactly that. In the prior two videos, we saw how we could install Django and how we could set up our project, parent, and our app, child. Now we want to start to add in a little bit of code to do that Hello World. But of course, before we do that, we're going to need something to serve up our website. Fortunately, we've already got that built in. That, if you remember the manage.py file, that entry point for our scripts, well, that includes, among other things, a little script called run server, which will start up our server. And in our case, because we've got that debug flag set to true, it's going to set up a dev server for us. So let me run this. And what you'll notice is we now get this big nasty error message telling us we have 18 unapplied migrations. Don't panic. It's okay. Right now, that's irrelevant. It would become important if we were working with the database, but we're not there yet. So for right now, we can ignore that. Instead, let's just open up the server. You'll notice it's created that right there. Control click. It opens up in my browser, and there is that default Django landing page. It tells me that my install worked successfully, gives me a nice congratulations. It's always nice to see, right? And then it tells me you're seeing this page because debug is set to true, and we have no configured URLs, which is also true. So let's break this down a little bit, and then that will then set the stage for where we're going to go. So it tells us that we don't have any configured URLs or URL confs, as they're known in Django terminology. And in a lot of other frameworks, you'll hear the phrasing route, and that's honestly the one that I like to use. And in a nutshell, what routing or a URL conf is all about is a user makes a request. They go to a particular URL. They do that by a post by submitting a form or maybe get by clicking a link. And we now need to run code in response to that. So we need to route their request over to some function or some method that's then going to perform the desired action. And that's how we're going to walk through this, that we will set up first that little function, and then we'll go ahead and create that route or that URL comp, which will then act as the middle ground. It will bring everything together for us. I'm going to open up Visual Studio Code here, and I'm going to go into my app or my Relic Cloud folder here, and I'm going to go into Views. So Views is where we will add in the code to display information out to the user. That's what a view is all about. It's how the user is going to view some information. And in my case, I'm going to create a function here. We can actually do classes as well, but that's a conversation for a different time. For right now, I'm going to focus in on my function, and I'm going to add in one parameter called request. Request will have all the information from the user and some other really neat stuff as well. So we'll have things like, all the cookies that were sent up, the form data, the query string, basically anything at all that's part of, well, the request is going to be inside of that parameter. For me right now, though, I don't need it, so I'm just going to ignore it, and instead, I just want to send information down to the user. I just want to send down a response. And I'm actually going to use a slightly different helper function here called HTTP response, which will allow me to send down some basic text that it will automatically wrap up as a response. So I'm going to say return HTTP response, hello world. Perfect. There we go. Because again, it wouldn't be official if we didn't do Hello World. So I'm going to return that value back. So that's the first part. There is now our view that we've created, and we've done this with a function. But the other part over here is now going to be that route. How are we going to take the user request and send that over? And again, remember that that is done by using a URL conf or URL configuration. You might remember from earlier that inside of our project, we have one global URLs PI file. This is going to be for our entire website here. So everything is going to be routed to here first, and then this will then go ahead and either maybe route directly to a particular view, or more commonly, it will route this out to or send this out to a helper URLs PI file. Now, you'll notice that I earlier added in a little comment here that this is my global one, this is for my project, and I just like to tag that because sometimes it can get a little bit confusing as to which URL's PI file you're in, especially because they'll typically have the same name. So, with that in mind, let's actually create a brand new one. I'm going to go back over here to ReliCloud, and I'm going to create a brand new URLs.py file. And you might be wondering, well, wait a minute, Christopher, why not just put everything inside of that one? Think about your projects. Think about your websites, that your routing tables are typically quite large because there's a lot of different requests that need to be mapped into different places and so forth. And so putting that all into one file, it's probably going to become unwieldy after a while. So we'll create separate ones to manage different portions of our website. So I'm going to create one for my ReliCloud app. So this will be for my app, which in my case is ReliCloud. There we go. Spelled with an L. Now, I want one big helper function. So I'm going to say from Django URLs, and that's going to be path. Import path. So path is going to allow me to identify how we're going to do our route. I'm going to create a brand new list here that's going to be called URL patterns. And you'll notice that I'm using a little extension here that has a set of snippets built in that I could, you know, take a little bit of advantage of. And that's inside of the extensions. If you go take a look for Django extensions for VS Code, you'll see that there. Now this URL patterns, this is a convention name. It does need to be URL patterns here. So that's what I've got set up. And now inside of this list, I can start adding in all of the different paths or all of my different routes. The default is going to be my empty string. The second parameter is where we want to send this to, and that's going to be over to our index view. So let's pull that in. I'll say from dot import views, and then we'll say views dot index. And then I'm going to give this a name. Let's give this a name of index. Right now, it doesn't really matter since I've only got the one, but eventually you're going to need to have the ability to look these up by name. So it's good to just get into that practice right now. I've now created my URL conf for my app, for ReliCloud. Now I need to register this inside of the global one. So let me go back over here to my project and let's bring in one more helper here called include. And now let's register a new path. So again, I'm going to say path, and again, empty string for my default. And then what I'm going to say is basically, hey, look, if it's not admin, just route everything else over here to that ReliCloud URLs PI file up here. So what's going to happen is my request will come in. It's not going to match admin. It's going to be an empty string. So it will come over here, and then it's going to get routed over to my URLs PI, and then it will see that path here, and then it will go, oh, okay, I need to call this index function, and then that will be routed over there. So that's how all of the magic behind the scenes is going to happen. All my files are saved. Let me come back over here to my browser, a real quick refresh, and now we've got Hello World. Now this is an official beginner demo and video series. So that is how we can create a view, how we can set up a URL conf or route, and how we can register all of that inside of our project.
Thank you.